Only 7 out of 54 countries abstained from voting to appoint Saudi Arabia to a UN Council for Women's Rights in the absence of the ability to vote no. That's according to the Swedish Foreign Ministry. However, most European countries which voted are still refusing to reveal which way their ballots were cast. Murad Gazdiev investigates.
It's remarkable. Some of the foremost democracies in the Western world, champions of human rights, voted for Saudi Arabia, where women arguably face more discrimination than in any other country, to join the United Nations Women's Rights Commission. And almost nobody wants to admit they did it. According to the Geneva-based human rights group UN Watch, at least 15 of the 22 countries you see here voted for Saudi Arabia. Now, it's all secret. They all cite confidentiality and bureaucratic rituals as the reasons why they won't admit to voting for Saudi Arabia. But the hunt is on. WikiLeaks is offering 10,000 euros for information about who Sweden voted for. The Norwegian opposition is demanding answers, calling on the government to reveal who it voted for. In the UK, the government is under pressure and has refused to deny voting for Saudi Arabia. And the one European country that was exposed as voting for Riyadh is already regretting its choice.
If we'd had the chance to discuss this at the government level, of course I would have argued that we don't approve it. I regret the vote.
According to leaked emails, the Belgian government knew exactly what it was doing. In fact, officials were allegedly ordered to inform Saudi Arabia about Belgium's vote in an apparent attempt to curry favor.
The rules of laws are being ignored. There are these secret meetings, secret trade-offs and secret deals being struck behind closed doors, which is shameful and a disgrace. In future, our time will be studied in history classes as the age or the era of hypocrisy, because that's exactly what it is.
Let's be fair. Saudi Arabia was almost certain to get in, even before the vote. The system is, well, interesting. There are only 4 candidates and 4 seats. No competition or opposition.
In votes of this kind, you can only choose to vote for a country or to refrain from voting. There is no option to vote no. Sweden never comments on how it votes in secret ballots.
That's right. You can't vote against candidates. You can only vote for or abstain. But what do we know? The intricate bureaucracy of the UN is beyond mere mortals like us. But with a spate of nominations to various human rights bodies, Saudi Arabia appears to be trying to change its image. Take this, the first ever girls' council in Saudi Arabia, notably lacking are actual girls. This picture went viral, made the rounds over the internet. The girls apparently were in another room, linked by a video feed. After all, it wouldn't do to have men and women mingle. In Saudi Arabia, that's illegal.
We contacted a number of countries who participated in the vote, requesting comment on whether they supported Saudi Arabia in the vote. The UK Foreign Office ultimately snubbed our query, saying the ballot was secret. While the U.S. State Department instructed us to contact their embassy here in Moscow. The German Foreign Ministry, however, referred us to a recent press conference where its spokesperson said such votes are traditionally not criticized or commented on.